Welcome to the Gevey Sim troubleshooting guide. I will introduce you to the new Gevey Sim. Well, it's not new, but it's compatible with a few versions, depending on what Gevey Sim you have. It should say in the front. The Gevey Sim is basically a chip where you place your SIM card, the one that obviously is not working, and you're able to unlock your phone. That way by it actually connecting to the emergency network, and from the emergency network it reroutes you, and you are able to connect to the towers and finally get a signal. The only problem with this is when you do power down your phone, for example, if your battery dies, or if you I guess most likely if your battery dies, or if you restart your phone. Power down your phone, you have to re-perform the same steps that we're about to follow right now. Okay, so again, this is the Gevey Sim here, and before you insert your Gevey Sim inside your phone, make sure you power it down. But the first step here that I have written is make sure you turn off your Wi-Fi as well as your 3G. I forgot to mention that your battery, try to keep a battery of 50% approximately. So I'm going to shut off the Wi-Fi here. Okay, Wi-Fi off. And, well, I can either shut off the 3G from the boss preferences, which I have as a shortcut, just like that. Or another way is if you don't have a jailbroken phone, then you go to General, Network, and 3G on top. It's already off on mine, but you can turn it off on yours if it's still on. Alright, well, okay, once you've done that, now you are ready to follow step number two. And that is, make sure that your lock screen passcode is disabled. That's a very important step. Why? Because when you'll see later, I'll explain later. Now, let's go to General. Okay, passcode lock, mine is on. So I'm gonna put my password in. Okay, there we go. Turn it off. Password again. Alright, now it's off. You're good to go. Okay, so here, you can put your phone aside. I'll just keep it here. Alright, so while this is going on, now third step that I've written here is power down your device. Again, make sure you don't put your SIM card, your Gevey Sim, with your SIM card while your device is on. You don't want to short circuit your Gevey Sim. Okay, power device off. Swipe. Alright, just making sure. Alright, next step here. Alright, so here's the problem with some Gevey Sims. Well, since you have a micro SIM, this is my AT&T network card. I'm not going to actually do anything to it because I still need it, but you're gonna have to trim the edge right there, because in order for it to fit, that little black on the upper right corner is pushing down a little. So I'm gonna put in another SIM card that is an international SIM card, and I already trimmed it down on the top portion, and it fits in there. And you just insert in the SIM. Also, it's a separate SIM tray. It's not the regular SIM tray that you use your iPhone. They give you a separate one. Alright, so now this is the important step right here. You keep swiping. Once you swipe, you should have a welcome screen that's in Japanese. But obviously that didn't work for me. So, we'll try it again. So, you power down your device, and retry. And sometimes it takes a few tries to get there, but it should be successful. Alright, so, okay, restarting device, and I'm going to do the same thing that I did earlier. So I'm going to swipe as soon as the lock screen appears, and voila, a welcome screen should appear, and it's written in Japanese. You see the word Gevey in there somewhere. And you make sure, okay, well, let me just tell you what to do before I accept. After this step here, you are going to see a signal bar on the upper left corner. It's going to be a one bar, just one bar appearing after you press the accept. And then you're going to dial, you can go to the phone, dial 112, and you're going to wait for about 1 to 1.5 seconds, no longer than 2 seconds, and then you hang up the phone. All right, so we're going to accept. And the upper left corner, where it says no service, we're going to wait for the one bar signal to appear. Once it appears, there it is. Once it appears, phone, dial 112. Again, 1 to 1.5 seconds, not no more than 2 seconds. You're going to call. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, and call. Okay, perfect. There we go. And at this point, if there is an error that appeared, you're going to have to should power down your phone and try it again. But there is no error, so we're good to go. Alright, so next step now, we're going to go to settings. Okay, now we're going to have to turn on and turn off the airplane mode. Alright, so it should be quick. Turn it on and turn it off. And then once you do that, there's going to be a SIM card failure error that should appear. So I'll show you right now. Okay, so we're set. Okay, airplane mode, it's off. Now we're going to turn it on and then turn it off quickly. You don't have to do it really quick, but just turn it off and turn it on. All right, I'm taking forever here. Okay, turn on, turn it off. Okay, good. SIM card, a SIM failure. It's perfect. Press OK. All right, now you wait a few seconds. It can take up to 30 to 45 seconds to appear. But there it is. See, that was quick. No SIM card installed. Which is the second error message. This is perfect. That's what you want to do. As soon as you press OK, airplane mode off. Right now you turn it on and turn it off again. Easy does it. All right, perfect. Now, I put my international SIM card inside, and I am in the United States. So if everything works perfectly, I should get the AT&T signal bar on the upper left any second now. And it's searching. Let's see if I'm lucky. Waiting. This is the best part. It should come up, hopefully, or else this video would be a failure. Getting nervous. Ah, there it is, AT&T. Perfect. Excellent. Okay, so there you go. And that is how you use the Gevey Sim. If any have any questions, let me know.